Yesterday we have studied about 100 dresses, one, the chapter we were doing, and in the chapter we have studied that Wanda Pentrowski, she was made fun of. She's a playing toy for everyone. Everyone used to make fun of her, and actually it was all started by Peggy and Maddie. Peggy, who was the most popular girl in the school, she is always making fun of her. She's waiting in the school outside in order to have some play or in order to have some with her, fun with her. What is the reason? Because she's always telling that she has 100 dresses, and Peggy, she gets irritated upon listening this, that why if she's not having and she's daily wearing that blue dress, then why she is saying that she has 100 dresses in her closet and all lined up, right? So till here we have read, and Maddie, she is stifled with the thought that Peggy should not make fun of her. Maybe she would be her next victim. And moreover, one day she would also be made fun of like that of Wanda Pentrowski. So now next afterwards, here on this page that is being displayed in front of you, today, even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad had not had to make fun of Wanda. So today also, although they were late to school, they were waiting for her in order to have some fun with her. But it was finally Maddie who was happy that at least they have not made fun of Wanda today. Because ultimately, inwardly, in her deep heart, she never wanted to make fun of Wanda, because she knew that it is not right to make fun of her. And if they are making fun of her, ultimately, it will be her one day who will also be in the same row of making fun. And Bhumika, I don't know what happened to you. You are again and again getting disconnected and again joining. I'm admitting you again and again in the classroom. So, she worked her arithmetic problems as absent-mindedly. So what she was doing her arithmetic problems, but she was doing it absent-mindedly. Why she was doing it absent-mindedly? It was because that her mind was engrossed in the thoughts that they should not do this to Wanda Pentrowski, because daily they were making fun of her and they thought that it is not right to make fun of her. 8 times 8, let's see. She wished she had the nerve to write Peggy a note, because she knew she never would have the courage to speak right out to Peggy to say, "Hey Peg, let's stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has." Now she was doing the calculations, but she was not making, or she was not getting her mind engrossed in doing the calculations. She was trying to do the calculations, but her mind was moving astray and it was again and again thinking of Wanda Pentrowski. So for that, she also thought that she is not having the courage to speak directly to Peggy, to say to her that, "Peggy, let us stop making fun of Wanda." So what she decided to write a note to her, and on the note she would explain about her feelings, that she is really feeling bad when they are making fun of Wanda. When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Peggy. So after doing her sum, because she is not she could never, you can say, sacrifice her image in front of the teachers also. She's doing her work. So when she finished her sum or her arithmetic problem that she was doing, she finally started writing a note to Peggy. Suddenly, she paused and shuddered. Shuddered means with sudden feeling. She has a feeling that what will happen. For she shuddered, she pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Peggy and the girls. Peggy might ask her where she got that dress that she had on, and Maddie would have to say it was one of Peggy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings, so no one in room 13 would recognize it. So she ultimately had a shudder, sudden feeling she had, and in that thought, deep thought, she was in deep thoughts. So she was visualizing herself standing in the schoolyard where Peggy and the other girls were standing around. She is so deeply moved by the kind of treatment that was being given to Wanda that she was picturizing herself that she is standing in the schoolyard and Peggy and other girls were standing around her. They were making fun of her, and to her they were asking from where he has got her new dress. And see here, one true revelation is it is made by Maddie. What she would say that it was one of Peggy's ones, means because she is wearing hand-me-down clothes, so ultimately it was not a new dress that she was wearing. It was actually what? It was one of Peggy's one. And Maddie's mother, who was good in tailoring, in stitching, she has disguised its, you can say, origin by adding new trimmings, by changing the laces, by adding on some more designs so that no one in room 13 would recognize it. If only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda, oh well. Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. What difference did it make? So now she was thinking that if Peggy would not listen to her and would go on making fun of Wanda, then she will definitely allow her, but she would not be a partner in that fun making of Wanda. But finally, she moved her hand in her blonde, means a brownish colored hair, golden hair, and so that she wanted to drive away that uncomfortable feeling that she was having. Which uncomfortable feeling she was having? The feeling that she's picturizing, she's visualizing herself standing in the schoolyard. What difference it make? Slowly, Maddie tore into bits the note she had started. She thought that if she will hand over the note, what change it will bring in Peggy? Would she ever stop making fun of Wanda? Finally, she lacked that courage in order to hand over that note which she was written to Peggy. She tore it into small pieces. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. Then finally she thought that Peggy was her best friend, and she is also the most popular girl in the school, in the entire school. And she thought that why Peggy should do anything wrong? She thought it means she is blinded by her friendship also. Moreover, she is afraid also of losing her friendship. And thirdly, she is also afraid of Peggy. Not because she would lose her friendship, but she was afraid that if she would stand against Peggy, then she would be her next target. And she did not have the courage to face all this kind of fun. As for Wanda, she was just some girl who lived up on Boggins Heights and stood alone in the schoolyard. And for Wanda, she is the only girl who is coming from Boggins Heights, and she is of course the alone girl in the entire schoolyard, because no one is playing with her, nobody is paying attention to her. In the class also, she is always sitting and on the second last seat among the rough boys. Though she is not imbibing those qualities of the rough boys, but still she's sitting there because no one is friendly with her. She scarcely ever said anything to anybody. She's the girl tight-lipped. She has never said anything to anybody. The only time she talked was in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. If one can listen to her, the only thing they can listen from her was about her 100 dresses. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with color trimmings. So now Maddie remembered that at one time she had talked about she had pale blue colored dress which is having colored frills, colored laces. And she remembered another that was brilliant jungle green with the red sash. Sash, you know, like whenever some beauty contest is there. Oh, yes. When you have your prefects and as well as martial ceremony or head girl office bearer ceremony, you wear a sort of, you can say, you wear a sash across your body on which prefect, marshal, or head boy, head girl is written. Okay, so this is called as sash. And yes, she has also told that she is having dress of bright green color, having red sash. You would look like a Christmas tree in that, the girls had said in pretended admiration. When she told this, the other girls laughed at her and they told, you would look like a Christmas tree in that kind of dress. And they were making pretended, means showing admiration. They were admiring, but ultimately they were insulting her. Thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Mary began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. So she was thinking about, Maddie was thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses. See how her mind, Maddie's mind, it was occupied with the thoughts of Wanda. So now the teacher has announced in the class that there is going to be a drawing and coloring competition. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys of designing motorboats. So what is the concept? The girls will design beautiful dresses and boys, they will design motorboats. They will make pictures of motorboats and the girls will make pictures of beautiful dresses. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal. So everyone, not only Maddie, everyone in the class was thinking that Peggy would win this girls' medal. Peggy knew better than anyone else in the room. So Peggy was having the feeling of admiration. She's feeling, yes, she's at the top of the world. But everyone was thinking about her goodwill. And she's feeling that nobody is comparable to her in that room. At least, that's what everybody thought. And everybody else in the class also thought that Peggy would win that competition. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. She's so good at drawing that she can copy any film star's face and you can easily recognize them. It means with precision, with complete details, intricate details, she is making all the images that one can easily recognize what this picture is about. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. And Maddie, she was sure that Peggy would definitely win the competition. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners. Then they would know. So after the competition, the teacher would announce who is the winning of the competition. And they would suddenly, and they would definitely come about to know that who is the winner of the competition. So the next day it was drizzling. Drizzling means light rain, or light raindrop falling from the sky. Next day it was drizzling. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. So they were coming to school, both the girls. There was just one umbrella, that is Peggy, and Maddie was taking shelter under it also. Naturally, on a day like this, they didn't wait for Wanda Pentrosky on the corner of Oliver Street. The street that far, far away under the railroad tracks and up the hill led to Bogans Heights. So on a day like this, they never wait for Wanda because they were standing on the corner of the Oliver Street, the street which was under the railroad tracks, and from there up to the hill, the road goes to Bogans Heights. They used to stand there in order to wait for Wanda and have some fun with her. Anyway, they were not taking chances on being late today because today was important. And today they did not want to get late because that day was really important for them, because today the teacher may be going to announce the result. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. Peggy, in an exciting manner, said, you know, Maddie, today Miss Mason will announce the result. Oh, I hope so. The minute we get in, of course, you will win, Peg. So she said, yes, yes, Miss Mason will announce the result. And she Pampered Peggy. Peggy, I know that you will win the competition, Peggy said eagerly. Hope so. She was wishing that she should win. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short and gasped. Gas means taking deep breath. They stopped there at the entrance and took a deep breath. There were drawings all over the room. So when they entered the room, what they have seen, that in the entire room, all the pictures that have been made by the students, both boys and girls, they have been displayed in the room. On every ledge, means shelf, windowsill, means the windows, dazzling colors and brilliant lavish designs all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. So beautiful designs, they were hanging, they have been placed on the windowsills on, you can say, wrapping papers. They were so, you can say, excited, and they were so amazed to see the display of the drawings that they felt very curious to know who is the winner. There must have been 100 of them all lined up. So they were just looking and were feeling that there are almost 100 designs that are all being displayed there. These must be the drawings for the contest. And they have guessed that these all are the drawings of the contest. They were, everybody stopped and wished or murmured admiringly. So everyone, what they were doing, everyone were admiring, means they were murmuring, not speaking in loud voices. They were just, you can say, discussing with each other. Yes, these are the dresses. These are the dresses, special dresses made by different people. And they were admiring how beautiful these are, beautiful designs. And as soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winners. So as everybody gathered in the class, the first period started, and Miss Mason, the teacher, she announced the winners. Jeff Peggles had won for the boys, she said, and his design for an outboard motor was on exhibition in room number 12, along with the sketches by all the other boys. She announced that for boys, Jeff Peggles has won the competition, and the design which he has made for outboard motor, it is displayed in room number 12. And all the other drawings made by the boys, they are also being displayed in room number 12. So everyone was excited. There was an air of, you can say, conversation among all the people, and they were discussing, yes, we will go and see that what kind of designs are being made by them. Then afterwards, as for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl in room 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs. Now the teacher is going to announce the result of the sketches that were made by the girls. The teacher announced that almost all the girls, they have submitted the designs of one or two sketches or one or two designs of dresses. But there is just one girl in this room number 13 who has drawn 100 designs. And everyone in this room number 13, means all the students of room number 13, should be proud of her. All different and all beautiful. The teacher admired the beautiful designs made by the girl. The teacher said all the designs were beautiful and all are different. In the opinion of the judges, any one of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. And what she said? She said, if I will talk about the judgment part, for the judges, all the drawings were so beautiful that any picture can win a design. I'm very happy to say that Wanda Pantronsky is the winner of the girls' medal. And what has been announced, that who has won the competition? It is Wanda Pantronsky who has won the competition. Now, unfortunately, Wanda has been absent from school for some days and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. So, Wanda was not present in the, she was not present in the school. She is absent for many days, for some days, but she's not present there in order to get this kind of admiration that she's getting from the teacher. Now, Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. Now, class, you may file around the room quietly and look at her exquisite designs. Exquisite means admirable, extremely beautiful. Now, the teacher said, yes, you can have a look over her designs across the room and you can enjoy her drawings that are being hanging around in the entire room. The children burst into applause. Everyone was applauding, clapping their hands and admiring the winners, some for boys and some for girls. And everyone was surprised that it is Wanda who has won the competition. How is this possible? And even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouths and whistle, though they were not interested in dresses. And even the boys, they were also whistling. They were tapping their feet onto the ground to make some noise in order to display their happiness. Although they don't have any interest in dresses, but still they were doing. Look, Peg, there's that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful? Now, Peggy and Maddie, they were also having a round for the dresses in the room displayed. So, Maddie was telling to Peggy, hey, look at that blue dress. She has told us about that. Yes, Peggy said, yes. And here's that green one, boy. And I thought I could draw. Yes. And she said that, yes, this is green one. And I think I could draw this one also. And I have also the idea that she has also told us about that dress. And finally, the first part of 100 Dresses 1 is over. So, the first part is completely devoted to making fun of Wanda Pentronsky, and who is just a figure of fun for everyone in the class. Everyone was making fun of her. She is just a, you can say, thing to play with, and that Peggy and Maddie were making fun of Wanda. But Maddie, from here you have come to know a lot about the characters of Peggy and Maddie. Okay? So Peggy, who is making fun of Wanda, but actually Maddie, she was not at all ready to make fun of Wanda. Why? She is not ready to make fun of Wanda because she thought that it is not wise. And actually she is also like that of, you can say, the other girl, that is Wanda. Because she is also wearing hand-me-down clothes. And it is just because of this reason that she has just one blue dress that daily she is wearing. And she is made fun of, and she deeply felt bad inside her heart to speak against it. But she was not able to gather courage or to muster up her courage in order to speak to Peggy about her, you can say, about the fun or the insult that they are giving to Wanda. So in the next chapter, we will read in the next week that how finally this comes to an end and what happened next. I hope that you have enjoyed this chapter a lot. This is very interesting chapter, and tomorrow we will discuss all the question answers of the chapter, right? So very interesting chapter, very beautiful chapter, so touching, so close to our heart, and you can easily identify it as your own story because this usually happens in the class, right? So this is all about this chapter. And tomorrow we will discuss the question answers, and that's all for today. Thank you.